Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today for this on-demand webinar about the five components required for successful communications intelligence analysis. So on today's presentation, I'm delighted to say that we're joined by some real experts in the world of law enforcement data analysis. And before we dive in, it's my pleasure to introduce them. So firstly, we have Giuseppe Francavilla. Giuseppe has a distinguished career and background in the world of law enforcement data analysis technologies. He began his career in the Italian financial police before moving to the commercial sector with roles at IBM and BAE Systems and several happy years also at Cambridge Intelligence. He's currently a consultant for Sistemi and Automazione, applying his experience to their extensive range of data analysis products. We're also joined today by Valerio Fumi. Valerio is a criminal lawyer and an intelligence analyst, and he works as a training consultant for Sistemi, helping their customers to extract intelligence from call data records, social media data, and he also has experience as a trainee judge, working on a number of cases covering white-collar crime, drug trafficking, and the mob. So not quite as exciting, but my name's David Burnett. I'm the head of sales at Cambridge Intelligence. We are a trusted partner of Sistemi and Automazione, and I have over 20 years of experience working in the cyber sector. Now let's quickly go over what we'll cover in the session. So I'll begin by discussing the policing data challenge, some of the misconceptions of how, you know, that's done, and then a little bit more in the reality and how modern investigative work is actually carried out. I'll then pass to Giuseppe, who's going to go on to discuss some of the history of Sistemi and Automazione, the organisations that they work with, the communications intelligence challenge and why it's an increasingly important aspect of law enforcement, before then passing to Valerio, who's going to demonstrate some of the concepts we'll introduce with a demo of TETRAS, which is Sistemi's widely used platform for law enforcement comment analysis and visualization. Then we'll come back to me. I'm going to give a little bit more information on Cambridge Intelligence and close today's session off. So the session is being pre-recorded, so we won't actually have a live Q&A as we normally do. However, we are, of course, keen to get people's feedback and questions. And if there's anything you'd like to ask me or Giuseppe or Valerio, then just submit your questions using the YouTube channel comment section below, and we'll make sure to get back to you. Just to dive into this, I think when most people think of police investigations, they think of something similar to this. I think we've all seen an image similar to this in TV shows and in films of the investigation wall, which is, you know, a sprawling map of paper and pins joined with bits of string by police officers investigating a single incident. The reality is nothing like that. The reality is quite different. So as you can see here, the reality is much more high tech. So whether it's call data records or open source intelligence like online social media profiles, incident and investigations, databases, financial records, body cam data, you can see them all here. Police investigations involve massive amounts of data. So, you know, police investigators and analysts need to be comfortable with complex data analysis. They need to know how to turn data into the intelligence that they need to either make an arrest or secure a conviction. So this leads us to the COMINT analysis challenge. COMINT, of course, being communications intelligence. COMINT is an increasingly important part of law enforcement. It allows investigators to connect suspects to incidents, locations, and other individuals, but it's not a simple task. It can be quite challenging. The data involved is big, it's varied, and it's extremely complex. Printout can include thousands of data points from phone calls and cell tower pings to online banking data, internet browsing history. It's a huge technical challenge before we even get, you know, to the analyst experience. So for the analyst, we like to say they're trying to connect people to digital shadows, I suppose you could call it. The investigator will often only have an IP address or a subscriber account number to work with. In reality, the human behind those accounts could be anyone. But if they can combine the subscriber information with a handset location or someone's social media history, then they can start to build a narrative. It's like putting a jigsaw together. They need to be able to combine all the pieces to understand the full picture. So there's also the challenge of ever-growing complexity. Crimes are increasingly planned and, you know, committed online, which then leaves digital footprints that need to be joined up and interpreted. So piecing together those records is a huge challenge for investigators and analysts. Then there's finally the resources. Policing is often actually slowed down by legacy technologies. So older, unintuitive desktop tools that don't work the way modern policing needs them to, combined with perennially tight resources around both people and funds. It's clear why comment analysis can be such a challenge. And part of the solution is to give your analysts the best possible tools for the task, which is why we've invited the team from Sistemi to join us today. So on that note, I'm going to pass you across to Giuseppe. I'll just stop sharing my screen, Giuseppe, so you can share yours.
Hi, David. Thanks for your introduction and also for this opportunity for me to catch up with Cambridge Intelligence. I'm really happy about that. So, Sistemi Automazione. Sistemi, it's quite interesting. So they are one of the major suppliers of investigative solutions to government, financial, and utilities, and organizations in a wide range of sectors in Italy and in Europe. They're really proud for being the very first one to introduce link analysis visualization software into the Italian community 25 years ago. So the graph really, it's important for them in their architecture because it achieves the function of fusing data coming from different heterogeneous data sets. It could be unstructured data, it could be relational graph databases, social media logs, and this fusion is made possible through the adoption of semantics all across their application. So the graph is important not only because of the fusion, but also because it becomes the main point of interactions with the whole application. So it's not just seen as an output device, but it's really the right place for the analyst to use all the functionalities available within the applications without having to leave the graph itself. And this is made possible through a vast range of drop-down menus and other controls which are within the user interface. We have been talking about the graph because it's the most prominent component. However, we should not ignore that there are other components that contribute to the success of the application itself. So in a way, if we want to use a metaphor, we can say in the same way in which an orchestra is really the combination of a variety of instruments. Each one has got its own characteristics. Each one plays its role, but they all contribute to the single performance and to the fusion itself, which is the symphony at the end of the day. In the same way, the analyst must be able to leverage different components inside the applications for each task he's got to perform each single time. Based on our experience, we can say that we have identified five components which are in a way mandatory if you want to have a performing analytical solutions. And these components are, first of all, the ability to acquire data, to structure this data, and to store this data in an efficient way. The second component, if you want, it's a set of analytics. The third component is what we've been looking at until now, which is basically the visualization itself that can be expressed at a connection level, but also it can be expressed through different dimensions, like the time dimension, the space dimension. The fourth component is vital because every time you achieve some results, you have to be able to share this data, these results with other people to export some of the results into a format that can be used by other applications. And finally, all this, like in the symphony we said before, it must be synchronized, it must be aligned. So both the information and the data and the applications can run in parallel and show the same truth, if you want, in every single time. As an example of the application of these five components, five principles, we want to show you quickly one of the applications developed by Sistemi, and this is called TETRAS. TETRAS is an acronym for Telephone Traffic System. The application started exactly 20 years ago when the telephone basically were really simple devices. This is why the name is telephone traffic. But in reality, personal communication has evolved, and the application has evolved in the same way. So they now include a variety of different ways to interact, to exchange information. It could be SMS, it could be IP connections, it could be bank connections or anything like that. So TETRAS is able to analyze all these different ways in which communication gets expressed. The application has reached the third version. It's been currently deployed to 800 sites all over the country in Italy. And it's basically a de facto solutions for comment analysis by all the analysts, which are over 2,000. Just a brief introduction. It's a client-server architecture. This is important because, for instance, when there are tasks that could take longer or require more resources, they are automatically assigned to the server. In this way, the client, the analyst, can get on with these tasks without having to wait for the completion of that import or whatever analysis is being performed in the background. The application reflects the way investigations are carried out. So it's divided into cases, into subcases, and it's a desktop application. However, there is also the possibility to have a web access, which is being designed specifically with management in mind, because they may want to have the flexibility to do quick query in complete freedom. And like David was pointing out before, the real purpose of the application is to be able to combine, I like the word, digital shadows, these details, you know, it could be email accounts, it could be subscriptions, it could be just metadata of a call or an IP address connections, and all these contributions to really define the profile of a real person, a real subject, a real organization. So let's look at these five components in detail. So the first one is the data acquisition. So TETRAS is very, very powerful from that point of view, because in most cases, this acquisition is completely automatic. So if you have a printout or a download of CDRs or other forms of communications, and you submit that to the system, it will be automatically, we have more than 250 formats. Others can be developed for different data providers by our specialists. The import is powerful also because there are a lot of tasks connected to that. When you import a list of calls, all the numbers included in that call will be normalized. That means they will be all set in a standard format, which is the international prefix, national prefix, and the number itself. A variety of import can be done, not just for CDRs, but also for IP network logs, for social media logs. You can import list of cell towers, list of people if you want. And in this latest version, we have also added the ability to ingest whatever extractions from mobile devices. It could be smartphone or tablets or PC laptops done through the most common standards available on the market. Second component, very, very important, is analytics. We have got a wide range of analytics, but at this point, I would basically hand the floor to my colleague, Valerio, who will go in detail about that. Thank you, Valerio.
So thank you, David and Giuseppe, for the flow and for the kind introduction. I'll start from the pre-analytic tool, and which is considered, which is fully considered one of the analysis tool of the powerful analysis tools of TETRAS 3. First of all, the software starts himself automatically, kind of a pre-analysis, as soon as the importation is over, and it will provide the analyst with a complete overview all over the data imported, no matter if they come from cell towers or a smartphone or another kind of different and several devices, and you will be able to display according to their occurrences the relevant or less presence of targets and elements of interest in your case, in your and in the files you have just imported. If you decide to drill into details and to taking a closer view of your data, you can display in stats and in a tab your files and immediately figuring out according to the stats how much traffic they have performed and with whom by choosing different and several type of charts like pie charts or histograms or bar charts and so on. Moving forward and starting to view real analysis tools, we have first of all the smart analysis, which is a summary of the most addressed needs of law enforcement agencies and police agencies, which we have collected through our 20 years experiences in this field. Like starting from this, we can perform from the easier, as you can see, kind of query, like the most contacted phone of a target in an extremely automatic and fast way. But we can also use this tool and this summary to perform really more advanced query, like in order to find out and to figure out if there have been people in the same place at the same time, like in this instance I have just performed for you automatically. One of the most ambitious, connecting to what David and Giuseppe just said, one of the most ambitious achievement of our software was connecting in the same directory every kind of entity, such as web accounts, email, and phone number, but not only, like information will come from social networks, social media, or manual and physical observation on police or law enforcement, was connecting all this data in just one directory. And this is what we have achieved through the behavioral analysis in the identity directory. From here, we can put finally the focus not only on devices and on and over calls, but we'll move the focus on people and on their relationships by figuring out and displaying their social patterns and their movements according to the people they have connected, they've been connected to the most, and the cell towers and the paths they have displayed all over the movements on foreign and national territories. According to this need to track down people movements and not only device movements, we have created a new kind of map visualization that we can start from every kind of target we decide to put the focus on. And I'm gonna show you an instance of this by sending to the map, in this case, just phone traffic records, but we can do that with every kind of information that has a form of georeferentiation, and you can perform, I'm gonna perform this this path. So from here, we can display every kind of movement through the map of our target simply by giving the order to the software, and we can also switch the speed according to your need. From here, you can confirm or discuss if there are truth or lies in witnesses or the criminal declaration by figuring out if the subject was exactly there or not or somewhere else. Finally, there is a strong device that makes easier giving feedbacks, which is the report function, and allow to the analyst to automatize for in a standard template every kind of information to make the feedbacks easier, and it can be customized and populated with the information not only from phone data and traffic records, but can also customize after or previously than the performing of the report. And you can distribute it automatically just after the performing of the report. That was just a short overview of the most important functions of the software. I thank you for your attention and I give back the floor to Giuseppe.
Thank you, Valerio. I'm going to quickly show you now how everything works together. Okay, so the first thing I like to highlight is the fact that we have two viewers actually available for the analyst. The first one is the IBM i2 analyst notebook, which has been traditionally the way to visualize this data. And in the last few years, Sistemi has also been creating an additional viewer through KeyLines. So the analyst can choose simply what he prefers like that. And then once he's made the selection, that viewer will be basically the standard viewer. Let's look at a simple way to analyze. Let's do a search. Here we've got an investigation here. I can easily switch the investigations by clicking on it. Let's look at the people involved in my investigation. I can see the list of people here. And I've got some intelligence recently acquired on one of the subjects on which I have very little at the moment. And it's this guy here, Sadak Huslam. So we select this person and then we'll basically send this person to the viewer. There you are. And from the viewer, like I was saying, we can retrieve all the information and perform other operations regarding this person. First thing is I'm going to visualize the type of data I've got in my case, in my investigation. I can see the person is associated to this lady. He's also been associated to these two SIM cards. This is his address, his residence, and finally is also connected to this phone, to this mobile phone. I can go back to the database and ask for the subscriber of this phone. I can see that this is the person that, according to the printout of the information I've got from the telecom provider, is the subscriber. I can also ask for other subscribers that could have the same name or a similar name. And they say that I've got four people actually with a similar name. For these people, then I can now query their phone, and here they are. And then for each one of these phone, I can also ask for the printouts, the type of information that I've ingested in the system. So each one of these printouts is available to be viewed in exactly the same way Valerio was showing you before, but I'm doing this in this case directly from the graph. You can see here it's quite a large number of calls included in this printout, 86,000. So I'm going back now. I'm not interested in this printout. So for the moment, I am basically going back on this information. And because these are the same people, what I can do is I can merge these people. I can combine them using the combo feature that's familiar to the people using the analyst notebook. Okay, and here I've got my guy. But let's see. So the intelligence I have about this person, about Sadak, let's see how we can progress that. We are going back to the query function. This is a particularly powerful query functions because you can ask for a huge number of parameters. So in this case, the intelligence I have is about a certain set of calls which were performed by this person between 8 and 11 in the afternoon, in the evening. The calls were fairly short. So I can say I'm only interested in the calls between 10 seconds and 2 minutes. And the other thing is I don't want to see all these calls because according to the intelligence I have, they were only voice over the internet protocol calls. So I do my query and here I get the list of calls. I can see them, but I can also go straight onto my viewer and basically commit all these calls to the viewer. So let's see what else I can find out. There is this lady, could be quite interesting. So let's see what I've got about her. She's connected to Sadak, as we have seen before. She's also connected to other people like Kirill here. It sounds interesting. So it looks like just out of the latest James Bond film almost. But there you are. Kirill is connected also to the same phone. And I can see that both Julia and Kirill have a connections with these two phones. Now, if you see the frame here, it's got the same color, yellow. That means that both phones are part of a list. Lists are very, very useful because it enables analysts to save subset of this information according to certain criteria. So these two calls phone probably belong to the same list. So I can see what is included in this list. There are all these phone numbers which were called by these users, and there you are. Here I've got this list of calls. This is interesting for me. This phone has a black frame, and the meaning of this color, it's a convention to express the fact that this phone has been involved in more than one case. So I can visualize the fact that this phone, in fact, has been involved in three cases here, and in four cases, actually. And I can also see whether this phone is included in some list, which is included. The list is the target list. This is very, very relevant because after each import, I've got the possibility to identify some of the numbers as my target, specific targets for the investigation. This could be the most active number or other numbers that I've decided to identify. So here I've got the list of targets. Again, this was the number we started from, but I can see there is a connections with this other number and with this other numbers here. Let me see if this number is also got some kind of list, which is has, okay. So the list in this case is, it's foreign numbers that have been in touch with it. And here I've expanded this, and I can see that these numbers are actually one a Chinese number and the other one is Hungarian. Now, the fact that I've got some of these foreign numbers here, I can see some Turkish number as well, makes me think. I've been working on foreign numbers in the same investigations before, and I've saved my graph into the database. So what I can do is I can go back to the database and retrieve my graph and add this graph to my existing graph. So I can see that it's a coincidence. This enlargement refers to the same number mostly. And then there is another set of numbers here, which are mostly provided by this telecom provider, Wind. I'm also thinking that I've got two additional pieces of intelligence. And these graphs, however, have been produced by another team that has been using Analyst Notebook. So I'm going now to open these two charts with the Analyst Notebook and look at it. So the first chart refers to two companies that have been identified during the investigation. Okay, this is the first company here. They are shell companies, or basically shelf companies. So they are just made up, but in reality, they're a way to cover this dodgy activities being performed by these people. One is based in the UK. There are a lot of, I can see some Russian names. And again, here is another company. This is based in Tunisia, and these are the people. Okay, so I'm going now to try and reuse this information in my graph, and this is it's very easy to do because what you need to do is simply select this data that you are interested in, and then let me see. So we select all data or part of the data, and we just drag and drop this data into my graph. There is a second graph that I'm also interested in merging in my investigation at the moment. Let me recall the second graph, which is this one. This is purely an import of telecom calls. Again, I can do the same thing. I can select all this data and then drag and drop this data into my key lines graph. Okay, and I can close now the analyst notebook. I don't need it anymore. And this is my my resulting graph. So on this side, I've got the data that I've been charting from my database. This is the data related to the two companies, and this is the data related to the printout that I've been importing through the analyst notebook. Now, I would like to point something that's quite interesting. You see, when you import calls, like in this case, generally you get this type of outputs where the icons, you know, are pretty the same, because at the end of the day, they're all telecom numbers. However, look at what the way TETRAS works on the data. It's much smarter than that, because not only identifies them as numbers, but also identifies the single telecom provider. And in case of a foreign number, it also identifies where this number is based. And also it puts the flag on the icon to identify the nationality of that number. Beside this data, I've got lots of additional information that I can consider. So for instance, in this connections here, I've got 10 calls. So if I go back, I can see these calls individually and I can do this both for the numbers that I've imported from the analyst notebook and also from the numbers that I had in my database here. I can see all these calls again, but I can do more than that. Because I've been dealing with all this disparate type of data, what I'm trying to do now is to find some elements in common. And the first one is to identify whether I've got the same phone number in this graph. And if I ask for this, basically I do get that. So you can see here, these two numbers have been merged. One was from my database, the other one was from the analyst notebook chart that have been imported, okay? I can do other type of matching if you want. So for instance, I can say, let me identify all the numbers that belong to the same telecom operator, okay? And here I am. So all this one are provided by Wind, and each one of these numbers still keeps his own identity. So although they have been combined, I'm still able to perform my activities, to expand this information and so on. Another matching I can do is, for instance, by country. I may want to identify all the phone calls that have been they belong to a certain country, a certain nationality, and so on. If I'm happy with it, I can save my graph onto the database, and we can call it, I don't know, David's investigation. And so I'm able to reuse this graph or to send this graph to my colleagues or to merge it with other information.
Okay, thanks Giuseppe, and thanks Valerio. That was great, really interesting. Just a reminder again for everyone that's watching, if you have any questions, you know, please do submit them using the YouTube comments section, and we'll definitely get to those and answer those for you. So before we wrap up, I'd like to give a little more information on Cambridge Intelligence. So at Cambridge Intelligence, we build data visualization tools that help to make the world a safer place, from law enforcement to cybersecurity and fraud detection. We work with organizations around the globe every day thousands of analysts that rely on our technology to join the dots in data and uncover hidden threats. And they do this with our data visualization products for connected data. So using our toolkits, it's quick and easy to build game-changing data visualizations and just deploy them anywhere, you know, to anyone. And as I said, we do this with our toolkits. So here we have them here. We have KeyLines. KeyLines is a JavaScript software development kit or an SDK. And that lets clients use the technology to build network visualization web components, which can then be embedded within their applications. Regraph, which is graph visualization toolkit designed for React developers. And finally, Chronograph, the latest addition to our suite of tools. Chronograph's a JavaScript software development kit, again an SDK, for building interactive timeline visualizations. And so using these toolkits, our clients take large volumes of often very complex data and create visual representations of that data in order to uncover things, you know, data-driven insights in a much more effective and manner. And in far less time. And if this is a challenge, you know, I'd like to see if this is a challenge that you know, anyone watching is facing, then we'd love to hear from you. Thank you to everyone on that note for the time today. Giuseppe, Valerio from Sistemi and Automazione. It's been a pleasure having you. And we hope, you know, you as viewers found it informative. And thank you for taking the time to watch the presentation.